بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. So after completing ولله الحمد the two works of الإمام الأجري Rahimahullah ta'ala, with the clarification of the upright and noble manners, the upright and noble manners of those who carry the Quran, and likewise the upright and noble manners of those people of knowledge, those whom Allah has benefited them with knowledge in this life and in the hereafter. We will study briefly in the next few classes a verse from the book of Allah Azza wa Jal and the hadith from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with regards to the clarification of the upright, lofty and noble manners and the beautiful and good Islamic conduct. Ayatun wa hadithun fi bayani makarim al-akhlaq wa jameel al-adat Jamil al-Adad. Now, so the ayah, al-ayah al-kareema alati nadrusuha, hiya qawlullahi ta'ala, khudh al-afwa, wa'mur bil-urf, wa'arid an al-jahileen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has commanded His Prophet in this verse, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, khudh, and Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And likewise, it's a command for him specifically, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also for his ummah to follow him in this. خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف وأعرض عن الجاهلين. Allah, He says to His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, show forgiveness, enjoin what is good, and turn away from the foolish. And turn away from the foolish, meaning do not respond to their foolishness with foolishness, and turn away from the ignorant, meaning do not respond to the ignorant with ignorance, and do not respond in that manner. خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف وأعرض عن الجاهلين. قال العلماء رحمهم الله إن هذه الآية الكريمة أجمع آية لمكارم الأخلاق مع الناس. The ulama, they have mentioned, barakallahu fikum jami'an, that this verse here, this noble verse, is the most concise verse with regards to the clarification of the noble and upright manners that one should abide by with regards to dealing with the people. With regards to dealing with the people. خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف وأعرض عن الجاهلين. It has been narrated from Al-Hasan Al-Basri, Rahimahullah ta'ala, he died in the year 110, from the great scholars of Tabi'een. He mentioned about Husn al-Khuluq, that it is Kaf al-Adha, wa Badhl al-Nada, wa Talaqatu al-Wajh. To summarize here, Al-Hasan al-Basri, he mentioned that the good manners and the noble conduct, it is to not harm others. Kaf al-Adha, Kafu al-adha, to refrain from harming others physically, and likewise harming them with the tongue and harming their hearts as well, and harming them in any manner, to refrain from that. This is good manners. Wa badhlu nada, and also to give generously. Al-nada yan al-jud wal-karam, to be generous with the people, to be generous. But generosity and al-karam is not specific to wealth. Only this is one type. But rather, بَذْلُ النَّدَى, it refers to being generous with the wealth, and likewise with the manner, and likewise with the speech, and generous with one's status and rank, in any way that one could be generous and kind to another and help a person in that way. This is all considered generosity and karam. Sometimes a person will be generous with his wealth, other time with his position and status and his rank, and he will help others in this manner. Other times by saying a good word to his brother and giving him advice, he'll be generous with his time. And Ibn Qayyim, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned the most virtuous and the best type of generosity is to be generous with knowledge. To be generous with knowledge. All of this is from the good manners. All of this is from the good manners. According to Al-Hasan Al-Basri, rahimahullah ta'ala, wa talaqatu al-wajh. Also, and having a bright face, and a smile on the face, a pleasant face. Not coming to the people and having a face that is balled up, or having a face that is looking at others harshly, or in accusation, or belittling them by one's stare and one's glare. Rather, meeting people with a smile on his face, or with a pleasant face, in this manner. All of this is considered good manners. So this verse here is the most concise verse with regards to these good manners. The ulama, they mentioned that this noble verse here is the most concise verse in the book of Allah, في بيان مكارم الأخلاق مع الناس, with regards to the clarification of the upright, lofty, and noble manners with the people. With the people. We know that the manners and the akhlaq, it begins with Allah Azza wa Jal. And likewise, after that, with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And we have discussed these affairs previously. Walillah alhamd. And likewise, there are manners that one must abide by with himself as well. And likewise, there are manners that one must abide by with the rest of the people. And this verse right here is the most concise verse with the clarification of this issue. لِبَيَانِ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ مَعَ النَّاسِ. نعم لبيان مكارم الأخلاق مع الناس. دولما they mention هذه الآية الكريمة تشتمل على ثلاث قواعد عظيمة مفيدة جدا في بيان مكارم الأخلاق. That this verse right here that we are studying, and we ask Allah to give us success to say that which is correct and to understand that which is proper and upright, and to be able to follow the knowledge that we learn and that Allah bestows upon us. That this verse here, خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف وأعرض عن الجاهلين, it consists of three great principles, three tremendous and beneficial principles with regards to the clarification of noble manners. And each one of these principles is a statement mentioned here. خذ العفو, this is the first one. وأمر بالعرف, this is the second. وأعرض عن الجاهلين, and this is the third one. Three fundamentals, great fundamentals, that all of the manners and noble and lofty manners return back to these affairs. To show forgiveness to the people and pardoning them, and not to hold them accountable for every last mistake and error that they fall into, and to enjoin that which is good, and to command that which is upright. And the best of that is at Tawheed, and following the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and being upon the way of the companions, radiallahu anhum, that's at the top. And likewise, after that, every aspect of good that Allah has commanded in His book, or that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam has commanded in his sunnah, and that the Salaf al-Salih, they were upon, and understanding and creed, and likewise in methodology and manhaj, as well as in conducts, conduct and manners, and acts of worship and the likes. خُذِ الْعَفْوَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَأَعْرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. It has been narrated by Al-Imam Al-Bukhari rahimahullahu ta'ala, that he mentioned with his chain of narration to Abdullah ibn al-Zubayr, radiyallahu anhuma, that he mentioned, ما أنزل الله إلا في أخلاق الناس, يعني هذه الآية, that Allah, He did not reveal this verse except with regards to the manners of the people. Allah, He did not reveal this verse except with regards to the manners of the people, how to deal with them. And one narration likewise, also in Sahih Muslim, Abdullah ibn Zubayr, he says, clarifying the meaning of this verse or the understanding, radiyallahu anhuma, he says, أَمَرَ اللَّهُ نَبِيَّهُ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَنْ يَأْخُذَ بِالْعَفْوِ مِنْ أَخْلَاقِ النَّاسِ. He says that Allah has commanded His Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to take the عَفْو مِنْ أَخْلَاقِ النَّاسِ. Yani to take that which is easy and that which is good for them and that which is easy for them without putting them in hardship or burden or expecting them to do something that is beyond their ability and the likes like this with regards to the manners of the people. We will see bi-idhnillahi ta'ala that the people, they're not all on one level and they're not all on one status and they're not all in one rank. And likewise, the manners and the characteristics of the people and their conduct and their backgrounds, so on and so forth, they're not all on one level and on one rank. Rather, the people, they're different in their temperament and the people are different in their manners. Some of them, they're very easygoing, and they can pardon easy. And other people, they become hot quickly, and the likes like this, and it's hard for them to forgive, and they have a grudge, so on and so forth. And the people, they're different. الناس معادن. So أخلاق الناس تختلف. The manners and the conduct of the people, it differs. وطبعهم كذلك تختلف, and their temperament and the way that they're created and the likes is different. Is different. Their tempers are different, and so on and so forth. So then we see that the first principle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in this noble verse, he says, خُد العفو. And this is what is being referred to here. خُد العفو من أخلاق الناس. This is what Ibn Abdullah ibn Zubair, he mentioned, رضي الله عنهما. العفو. ما معنى العفو? What is the intent of the word العفو here in this verse? Ibn al-Athir, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned in his book, النهاية في غريب الحديث والأثر. النهاية في غريب الحديث والأثر. It's a book that is written about the explanation of the words that are not well known or commonly used in the narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It's a science from Mustalah Hadith known as غريب الحديث. Ibn Athir, rahimahullah, he has a work and called النهاية في غريب الحديث والأثر. It's one of the most reliable and return to books of غريب الحديث that we have today. Rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned in this work, and he says, clarifying the hadith of, or the narration of Ibn Zubayr radiallahu anhuma, هو السهل والمتيسر. العفو in this verse, خذ العفو. And he is translated to mean show forgiveness. But the intent here, and how do we understand showing forgiveness to the people? It's a vast understanding, and it's very, very beneficial to learn the meaning of this and what is intended by this, and to strive to deal with the people in this manner. خُذُ الْعَفُوُ. He says, هُوَ السَّهْلُ وَالْمُتْيَسِّرُ. This is that which is easy. This word الْعَفُوُ, it means something that is easy and is facilitated, and it's not hard. He said, أَمَرَهُ, يعني النبي, أمره أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أمره أن يحتمل أخلاقهم ويقبل منها ما سهل وتيسر. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has commanded his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to bear the manners of the people and to accept from them that which is easy and that which is facilitated for them, that which is easy and simple for them and not hard. And so the people, they're different in their manners. Some of them, they are educated, and some of them, they have good self-restraint, and some of them, they pick the best words to speak and to say whenever they speak, and other people, they speak before thinking, and they're hasty in their speech and their action and their conduct. And some people, they're very generous and they're very kind and they're very courteous. Other people, they're very rude and they're very harsh. This is their temperament. This is the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created them, and this is inside of them. And the people, they're different in their manners. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's been commanded by his Lord, خُذُ الْعَفُوُ. يعني من أخلاق الناس, to take that which is easy from the people. So whenever the people who are courteous and nice, they do good, one accepts that alhamdulillah, and he is thankful for this, and this person is praiseworthy for his manners. But likewise, whenever the person who is rude, or the person who is harsh, or the person who has bad manners, if he does something good, even though it's in a lesser manner, he will accept that from them. He will accept that from them. And he will deal with him accordingly. And he will know that this person, he's not on the level of that person. And that each one he will be dealt with properly and accordingly. But he wouldn't expect the person who's known for being rude and known for being harsh, and he's known for having bad manners and having bad temperament, known for snapping and speaking quickly, that he's going to deal with him in the best way. He's going to come to him smiling. He's going to come to him ready. Somebody who's known to be greedy, and somebody who's known for these attributes of stinginess and the likes like this, whenever one deals with him, he's not going to expect him to be generous and to give him a great deal if he's doing a bargain with him in the market, for example. So one will deal with him accordingly. And whatever he deals with, alhamdulillah, it's all good. And he will learn how to move like this with the people. And he will accept from them their manners and their conduct. This one is kind, and this one is courteous. This one is harsh, and this one is rude. And this manner he deals with the people. خُذُ الْعَفُوُ. يعني ما تيسر من الناس وما سهل من أخلاقهم. يعني that which is easy for them to do. Some people, it's hard for them to smile. Some people, it's hard for them to be courteous. Some people, it's hard for them to pardon. This person who is known to be like this, we have to deal with them in that manner. We have to deal with them in that manner. And not in that same way, not dealing with them like that, but rather knowing that they're like that and accepting that from them, and then making the proper movements and speech in order to deal with this person in the best light, without falling into any quarreling and argument and the likes like this, and accepting that from him. This person is rude in his conduct and his manners. Alhamdulillah, I deal with him in the best manner. I expect that from him. Now he says, so, and he commanded him, أن يحتمل أخلاقهم ويقبل منها ما سهل وما تيسر ولا يستقصي عليهم. And likewise, he accepts that which is easy from them. Those people who are nice, it's easy for them to be nice. The people that are rude, it's hard for them to be nice. He will accept that from them. And he will deal with them accordingly. Likewise, to not go into great details and be critical with regards to their affairs, and going and examining in detail and going into their affairs, and trying to find intricate details in the issues that they're mentioned and that they're involved in, not to be spying on the people and the likes like this, and trying to find out the reality of their inner affairs. Rather, we accept from the people the manner that they show and that they come to us. نَكْبَرُ مِنَ النَّاسِ الظَّوَاهِرُ وَلِلَّهِ الْبَوَاطِنُ. That we accept from the people that which they show us, and that which is in the inside of the people in their hearts, this is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the people who show khayr, and the people who show that they love the sunnah, and that they love the people of knowledge, and they're upon the straight path of the salafiyyah, then we accept that from them, alhamdulillah. If that's what they show us, and that's what they're known for, then we accept that, and what is in their hearts is returned to Allah. But the people who are contrary to that, and what is apparent from their actions and their statements and their likes and from their companions, so on and so forth, is contrary to that, and contrary to what is correct in creed and in belief and in manners and conduct, then likewise, we will accept that, and we will see them like this, and we will not trust them and bring them close. And this is something that is clarified in Sahih Bukhari in the hadith of Umar, radiyallahu anhu, in the narration of Umar, radiyallahu anhu. So likewise, with regards to the clarification of this verse and its meaning, it has been mentioned in Tafsir al-Baghawi, خُذِ الْعَفُوُ. We're talking about the first qa'ida. The first qa'ida, al-qa'ida al-ula min هذه القواعد الثلاث, خُذِ الْعَفُوُ. وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَعَدِ الْأَنَّ الْجَاهِلِينَ. The first one, خُذِ الْعَفُوُ. Naam, Mujahid, he mentioned, rahimahullah, the great student of Ibn Abbas, radiyallahu anhuma, he says, يعني الْعَفْوَ مِنْ أَخْلَاقِ النَّاسِ وَعَمَالِهِمْ مِنْ غَيْرِ تَجَسُّسٍ. Meaning that which is easy, and that which is simple and facilitated, that which is easy from the manners of the people, and that which is good from the manners of the people, and from their deeds and from their actions, without spying on them. He makes an example now, and he says, وَذَلِكَ مِثْلُ قَبُولِ أَعْذَارِهِمْ. And this is like, for example, accepting their excuses. Accepting their excuses, whenever they make an excuse or their apologies, likewise. From this, being easy with the people and accepting their manners from them is, for example, the one who makes a mistake or the one who is in error, that whenever he realizes that and he makes an excuse for himself or he apologizes, that this will be accepted from him. And this is from the noble and the lofty manners, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he clarified in the hadith of Anas radiyallahu anhu, and it's collected by Tirmidhi rahimahullah fi jami'ihi, kullu bani adam khatta'. وَخَيْرُ خَطَّائِنَا التَّوَابُونَ. That all of the children of Adam, they're sinners and they make mistakes. They fall into sin and the likes. And the best of the sinners are those who repent. So if a person, he falls into sin, or if he takes the right of another, or if he mistreats them or abuses them, or he does something that is not correct in dealing with them, and then after that he realizes that, and he has remorse, and he repents, and then he apologizes to that person and presents his excuse, or he mentions that he has, he apologized to that person and he mentioned himself that he was in wrong, then that person, he should accept that from him. And he should accept that from him. He should accept his excuse. If he has an excuse and his apology likewise, he should accept that from him as well. Just like a believer would love for Allah to pardon him, he should pardon the people. Just like a believer should love that his faults be covered and not displayed, he should do likewise for the people. Namso al-Mujahid, he says, al-afwa yani al-afwa min akhlaq an-nas wa a'malihim min ghayri tajassus wa dhalika mithlu qabuli a'dharihim wal-afwi wa musahalati fi tarki al-bahth an al-ashya' wa nahwi dhalika. Yani to accept their excuses and to accept their excuses and their apologies, and also to pardon them and to deal with them easily and to have easy transactions with them, and easy dealings with them, and to not go into great details in their affairs, and to pry into issues, and to go into details about intentions or what they are doing or what they did and the likes like this, trying to uncover faults and mistakes. This is in general within this affair. But there is an exception here that I would like to mention that it must be clarified. And this is with regards to the children and the likes like this. That with regards to the children, a father, he has to be alert and he has to be aware. And he wouldn't just leave them alone to do whatever they like on the internet, for example, or on the phones and the likes like this, for example, or on social media, when not being checked. We wouldn't say, no, from the good manners, khudr afu, that you leave them to do what they like and you never check on them and you never examine the affairs and you never look up after them and follow after them and see what they're looking at and who they're speaking with. La. In this case, it's different because this person, he's wali al-amr. This person, he's mas'ool. And hadha al-walid. He's held responsible for that child. He's held responsible for that child and he's the guardian of that child and it's incumbent upon him to keep him safe. And the children, they don't know what's good for them and what's not good for them. So it's a different issue here. So for a father or a mother to look into the phone of a child, this is good and this is praiseworthy and this is right. Now, to look into what the child is looking at or to restrict them in that which they look on the internet and to look at what they have been looking at, so on and so forth, or who are they associating with, and to check into these affairs, this is permissible. And like this, Shaykh al-Fawzan, Hafidhahullah ta'ala, he has mentioned the fatwa, that this is permissible. With regards to the children. So this here, what is referring to here is in general, and to not to pry into the into people's business and not to examine their affairs in great detail, searching out their faults and the likes like this. And if this is with the general people. As for with the family, then a person, it's incumbent upon him to keep his family safe from evil and to keep them far away from falling into the traps of shaitan and the people of misguidance and the ways of wickedness and evil. Now, so this is a very important point. Likewise, this statement, خُذْ الْعَفُوْ وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ وَعَرِضْ عَنِ الْجَاهِلِينَ. Al-Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullahu ta'ala, he, in his commentary, in his tafsir, and likewise, he has another brief summarized commentary called Taysir al-Latif al-Mannan fi khalasati tafsir al-Qur'an. It's a very similar tafsir of this particular verse in his famous tafsir, if it's not the same wording. But we read from this. The benefits that he has mentioned, rahimahullahu ta'ala, with regards to the first qa'idah, the first principle, khud al-afu, show forgiveness to the people. Show forgiveness and pardon, be easy with them. That's the meaning. Show forgiveness to them and pardon with them and be easy with them. And don't be hard on them and don't expect them to do things that they're not able to do. And do not burden them to do things that they're not capable of doing except with extreme hardship. And do not expect the people to always be exactly how you would like them to be. خُذْ الْعَفُ. Do not expect the people, any in general, the wife, or the husband, the child, the father, the mother, the neighbor, the boss, yani the people, the brother, the sister. Do not expect them to always be exactly how you would like them to be. خُذْ الْعَفُ. If they do good, alhamdulillah, and the one who is upright and pious, the good that he does is easy for him, and the one who is tried with lowly manners and the likes like this, if he does some good, even though it's lesser, alhamdulillah, you accept that from him. You don't expect him to be like the one who was upright and good. And the likes like this, خُلْ الْعَفُ مِنْ أَخْلَاقِ النَّاسِ. Deal with the people that which is easy from their manners. Those who have lofty manners, you deal with them correctly, and those who have lesser than that, likewise, you accept the good from them that they have. You accept the good from that they have, and whatever they have of shortcomings, you make supplication for them, and you make dua for them, and you ask Allah to rectify their affair, and you advise them in the best manner. وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ. وَأْمُرْ بِالْعُرْفِ. Al-Imam al-Siddi, he says, rahimahullahu ta'ala, وَمَا يَنْبَى, excuse me, he says, هَذِهِ الْآيَةُ الْكَرِيمَةِ جَامِعَةٌ لِمَعَانِ حُسْنِ الْخُرُقِ مَعَ النَّاسِ. That this noble verse is concise and collects all of the meanings and the understanding of having good manners with the people. He says, وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِلْعَبْدِ سُلُوكُهُ فِي مُعَامَلَتِهِ وَمَعَاشَرَتِهِمْ فِي مُعَامَلَتِهِمْ وَمُعَاشَرَتِهِمْ. Yani he says, وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِلْعَبْدِ سُلُوكُهُ فِي مُعَامَلَتِهِمْ وَمُعَاشَرَتِهِمْ. And that which is incumbent and required and expected for the servant to behave, the manner that one should behave with regards to dealing with them, yani the people, and also with regards to living alongside them. This verse here has gathered all of the issues with regards to this and summarized that in these few words, Alhamdulillah. So the Sayyidi, he says, فَأَمَرَ تَعَالَى, Allah, he has commanded, بِأَخْذِ الْعَفْوِ, he has commanded to take al-afu, and to show forgiveness and pardon, and to be easy with the people. وَهُوَ مَا سَمَحَتْ بِهِ أَنفُسُهُمْ وَسَهُلَتْ بِهِ أَخْلَاقُهُمْ مِنَ الْأَعْمَالِ وَالْأَخْلَاقِ. And al-afu, he says, what is being referred to here in this noble verse is that it's what's easy for their souls to perform, and that which is easy for their manners, with regards to their manners and the actions and their conduct. Their actions and their conduct. And هو ما سمحت به أنفسهم وسهلت به أخلاقهم من الأعمال والأخلاق. يعني that it's that which is easy for their souls to perform. The people, they're different. That which is easy for them, you accept that from them. That which is easy for them in their manners, and that which is easy for them in their deeds and their actions, you accept that from them. Now, he says, rahimahullah ta'ala, خذ العفو وهو ما سمحت به أنفسهم وسهلت به أخلاقهم من الأعمال والأخلاق. He says, بل يقبل ما سهل. Now he says, rather he should accept that which is easy. He should accept that which is easy from them. وَلَا يُكَلِفُهُمْ مَا لَا تَسْمَحُ بِهِ طَبَائِعُهُمْ. And he should not hold them account or try to require them to do that which their temperament will not allow. Their characteristic and their temperament and their tempers, the way that they're created, will not allow them to do it. Some people, they're not able to comprehend and understand or even to perform certain actions. Some people, it's too hard for them to do certain issues and to act in certain manners. From the adults to the children. From the adults to the youth to the children. Now, so we should not expect people to do that which is their manners and their selves is not able to perform. He says, وَلَا يُكَلِّفُهُمْ مَا لَا يُطِقُونَ. مَا لَا يُطِقُونَهُ. And we should not require them to do or hold them accountable to do something that they're not able. That they are not, they're not able. So we should not think that all of the people, they are on one status or one level with regards to manners. The people, they're not all together on one status or one level with regards to manners. As has preceded, some people, they're very courteous and they're very kind and they can overlook faults, and somebody may take their right from them and it will not bother them much, and they can back down from that easily and their heart is not bothered. Other people, just one wrong thing and he'll snap and he will raise his voice, or the life's like this. And some people, they're rude and they're not kind, and this is their temperament and the way that they have been created. So then the people are different, so it's incumbent to deal with each one accordingly. To deal with each one accordingly. All the people, they're not the same. Now he says, بَلْ عَلَيْهِ أَنْ يَشْكُرَ كُلَّ أَحَدٍ مَا قَابَلَهُ بِهِ مِنْ قَوْلٍ وَعَمَلٍ وَخُلُقٍ جَمِيلٍ. But rather, what is incumbent for him, and for the slave, for an individual to be upon, is to accept every, and to thank the individual, or thank every individual for that which he deals with. And that which he comes and brings from statement and from action and from beautiful and nice and good manners. وَمَا هُوَ دُونَ ذَلِكَ. وَمَا هُوَ دُونَ ذَلِكَ. Some people, they're very generous, and maybe they will help with their time or their wealth. Other people, they're stingy. So the one who's generous, maybe he will help a lot, and he will be very beneficial for an individual and help him in many areas of his life. Another individual, he may be contrary to that. But still, if he does come around and does some help, maybe, for example, he will help for only for a few minutes, or he will only, if he gives charity, he will only give $10. This is because this is his temperament, and this is the manner that he's created. Like this, then if he does that, you say, Alhamdulillah, and you accept that from him. Jazakallahu khayra. Jazakallahu khayra. And you deal with the people accordingly, everyone accordingly, and you be easy with the people. You wouldn't expect him to give all of his wealth. He's not like that. This person is different from that. Or the one who is rude. For example, sometimes you will find a brother will come to the masjid and he will pray and then move from his space. Another brother may come behind him and not know that that was his space. One brother may come back and find somebody in his space and say, Alhamdulillah, it's all good. Yani, although it's my right, I'll just back away. I don't want to bother that brother, and I'll let him stay there. And I'll let him stay there. And I'll go to another space, even if it's behind the line, for example. Just, yani, Alhamdulillah, he'll pardon that person. He didn't know that I was there. And he will let him stay there, like this. Some people, it's easy for them like that, and their heart is clean, Alhamdulillah. And he'll go to the next place. Another brother, maybe he also be similar like that, but instead, he won't let him keep the space. He'll go to him gently, and he'll go, excuse me. Barakallahu fik, salamu alaykum, akhi. Actually, I was here. I had to move for a reason, and this is my spot. I've been here for a moment now. Barakallahu fik. Can I have my spot back, please? You can sit right next to me. Or there's another spot over there. Actually, I was here before. And the Prophet, he said, and the first one who comes to a place, then that place is for him. Naam, though, naam. The first one who comes to a place, that place, he has the right to it, like this. And he'll mention, like, oh yeah, yeah, sure, of course. And he'll mention in a beautiful manner. Another brother, he may come along and he may see somebody in his spot right there, and he'll get hot. He'll get hot. He's tempered like this. He'll get hot and he'll see, what is that man doing in my spot? Alhamdulillah. And he'll come over to tapping on the shoulder. Don't you know I was right here already? You don't see my cheese. You don't see this, or you didn't see me standing right like this. The people are different like that. So that person who's sitting there, he has to know that. And the one who comes in the nice manner, jazakallah, and the one who comes in the rude way, likewise, afwan akhi, he knows he's a rude brother. He knows he's a tempered brother. He knows he gets hot easy. How does he deal with him? Afwan, barakallah fik, I didn't know you were there. Jazakallah khair, nam, I apologize. Like that, in order to keep the situation cool. خُد الْعَفْوَ يعني من خلاق الناس من ما سهلت بهم. It's not easy for that brother to be kind. It's not easy for that brother to see somebody sitting in a spot and to be calm. يعني, because that's the type of person that he is. يعني, this is not making excuses for people. The people who are like that, يعني, they have to try to rectify their manners. But this is how we deal with the people. Not everybody is the same. He says, بَلْ عَلَيْهِ أَنْ يَشْكُرَ كُلَّ أَحَدٍ مَا قَابَلَهُ بِهِ مِنْ قَوْلٍ وَعَمَلٍ وَخُلُقٍ جَمِيلٍ وَمَا هُوَ دُونَ ذَلِكَ. He says, وَيَتَجَاوَزُ عَنْ تَقْسِيرِهِمْ وَيَغُضَّ طَرَفِهِ عَنْ نَقْصِهِمْ. He said, وَعَمَّا أَتَوْ بِهِ وَعَمَلُوهُ بِهِ مِنَ النَّقْصِ. He says, but rather also he has to overlook their deficiencies. The people, they have deficiencies. We all have deficiencies. Some of them have more than others. And some people, their deficiencies are exposed more than others. Some, they have few deficiencies and they're not exposed except rarely. Other people, they have many deficiencies and they're exposed all the time. The people are different. وَأَنَّاسُ مَعَادٍ وَأَنَّاسُ مَعَادٍ. So the Shaykh is telling us that everyone, he has to deal with everyone accordingly like this. And the good that they have, he accept that from them. And even if they have lesser than that, he deals with them properly. And the issue here is to never deal with the one who is harsh or rude with rudeness. And he rather to accept that from him. Oh, he's a rude individual. Maybe he's from a bad neighborhood. Or maybe he didn't learn the manners of the Prophet ﷺ. Yes, maybe he's struggling with the issue of khuluq. You think about this and you give him excuse and you deal with him in this manner like this. Afwan, barakallahu fik, jazakallahu khairan, naam, I will move. Like this. And he's just for an example. وَيَتَجَاوَزُ عَنْ تَقْسِيرِهِمْ. And he will also overlook, he will pardon them. يَتَجَاوَز يعني, he will pardon them and he will not hold them accountable for the shortcomings that they have. This is very important to understand, especially in the household and the people who see each other day in and day out. And also the ones who they have dealing with and so on and so forth. With the people and mankind in general. يعني خُذ العفو من أخلاق الناس. يعني عموما كافة. And he had to deal with the people, and he specifically. But I want to, the brothers and sisters to listen and think about how they can benefit this directly in their homes. And directly with the people they deal with in their lives immediately. نَمْ وَتَجَاوَزُوا عَنْ تَقْسِيرِهِمْ. And they overlook or they don't hold them accountable for their shortcomings. وَيَغُضُّ طَرَفَهُ عَنْ نَقْسِهِمْ. And he lowers his gaze, yani, meaning that he will overlook their deficiencies. He will overlook their deficiencies. Some people, they try their best, but we have deficiencies. So even though, no matter how hard one tries, sometimes he still makes a mistake. He will maybe sometimes pick the wrong time to say something, or pick the wrong time to do something. And then this could cause a problem for another person, so on and so forth. That other person has to learn how to accept these situations and deal with them properly. This is the benefit from the verse, خُذِ الْعَفُ. خُذِ الْعَفُ. Know that the situation is like this, and to deal with the people gently, and to deal with the people in the easy way, and to know that sometimes this occurs from people, and to accept that from them, and to not any act in a manner that will not be praiseworthy in the outcome. that would not be praiseworthy in the outcome. He says, وَأَمَّا أَتَوْ بِهِ وَعَمَلُهُ بِهِ مِنَ النَّقْصِ. And likewise to overlook that which they have done and the way that they have dealt with them from the actions of deficiency. Yani not giving the person their right property or taking the right of another individual. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, he died in the year 728. He mentioned in Majmu'a Fatawa, he says, إِذَا وَجَدَ الْعَبْدُ تَقْسِيرًا. Yani with regards to this taqsir and this naqs, yani the shortcomings and the deficiencies of individuals. He says, إِذَا وَجَدَ الْعَبْدُ تَقْسِيرًا فِي حُقُوقِ الْقَرَابَةِ فِي حُقُوقِ الْقَرَابَةِ وَالْأَهْلِ وَالْأَوْلَادِ وَالْجِيرَانِ وَالْإِخْوَانِ فَعَلَيْهِ بِالدُّعَاءِ لَهُمْ وَالْإِسْتِغْفَارِ. Allahu Akbar. This is what one should deal with and how one should move. He says, if the servant, he finds shortcomings in the rights of his relatives and in his family and his wife and in his children and in his neighbors and in his brothers, then he should make dua for them and he should ask Allah to forgive them. Subhanallah. Many people, if they find shortcomings, and times we'll find shortcomings in others and we belittle them. Even some may fall into backbiting about them, or carrying tales about them, or they may belittle them, and so on and so forth. This is not correct. The one who finds these shortcomings in his relatives, shortcomings in deen, shortcomings in manners, shortcomings in worship, shortcomings in conduct and fulfilling the rights of others, if one finds these in his relatives, or in his family, or in his children, or in his neighbor, or in his brethren, his brothers, his blood brothers or his brothers in the deen, what should he do for them? What should he do at this time with the one who sees this in others? He says, فَعَلَيْهِ بِالدُّعَاءِ لَهُمْ وَالْإِسْتِغْفَارِ. He should hasten to supplicate for them and to ask Allah to forgive them. To supplicate for them, to rectify their affairs. And if he has bad manners, to rectify his manners. If he's in a situation he's not praying properly, to ask Allah to allow him to pray, to guide him to salat. If he's misguided from the sunnah and he's upon bid'ah, to guide him to the truth, so on and so forth. To make dua for them and ask Allah to forgive them. And to ask Allah to forgive them. This is what the great scholar Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah has mentioned about the situation. We continue reading the benefits of Shaykh Abdul Rahman bin Nasir Sa'di, rahimahullah ta'ala. He says, وَلَا يَتَكَبَّرُ عَلَى صَغِيرٍ لِصِغَرِهِ. And he will not boast and be proud and arrogant over the small or the young or the one who is lesser because of his youth or because he's little. The one who is صغير, لَا يَتَكَبَّرُ عَلَيْهِ لِصِغَرِهِ. Just because he's little or he's lesser and the likes like this, or he's lower or he's younger, then one would not boast to be arrogant above him and thinking that one is better than him. And so on and so forth, just because he's small, or just because he's younger, or just because he's at a lower status or rank, so on and so forth. لا. وَلَا يَتَكَبَّرُ عَلَى صَغِيرٍ لِسِغَرِهِ وَلَا نَاقِسِ الْعَقْلِ لِنَقْسِهِ. Likewise, he's not boastful and arrogant and proud with regards to the one who has a deficient understanding, and his intellect is deficient because of his deficiency. Rather, the one who has this deficient understanding, whose intellect is deficient, you accept that from him. And the good that he has, you accept that from him, alhamdulillah. And that which he has from harm, you deal with that in the best manner. And likewise, the one who is young, or the one who is a youth, or the one who is small, or the one who is under you, like this, and the one who is under an individual, then he will deal with him likewise. He will not be arrogant against him, or proud against him, I'm better than you, or I'm higher than you, I'm older than you, you're little, and I have a higher status, like this. He will not be arrogant with regards to him. Rather, he will try to accept that from him, and help him, and the likes like this, and to guide him, that which is the best. And if he's someone who's younger or lower, then he will try to be a role model for that individual. Nam upon khayr, khudwatun hasana. He says, وَلَا الْفَقِيرُ لِفَقَرِهِ. Likewise, he will not belittle and boast and brag and be arrogant with regards to the one who is a faqir, the one who is poor because of his poverty. He says, بَلْ يُعَامِلُ الْجَمِيعِ بِاللُّطْفِ وَمَا تَقْتَضِيهِ وَمَا تَقْتَضِيهِ الْحَالُ الْحَاضِرَةِ. He said, rather, he will deal with all of these different type of people with gentleness. He will deal with all of these different type of people with gentleness. And in the manner that the particular situation and affair at hand necessitates. He says, وَبِمَا تَنْشَرِحُ لَهُ صُدُورُهُمْ. And that which the people, when you deal with them, you will deal with them in a manner that their hearts will find contentment in dealing with you. that you will not enter into their hearts any type of rancor or any type of haraj, or make them feel hard, or make them have hardship in their heart, or any type of bad feelings. Rather, whenever one deals with them, he will deal with them in a manner that their heart feels content and good and at ease, in the manner that he deals with him. He says, so, وَيُوَقِّرُ الْكَبِيرُ وَيَحْنُوا عَلَى الصَّغِيرُ وَيُجَامِلُ النَّذِيرُ, that he will honor and respect the elder, and he will be merciful and kind to the youth, and likewise, he will be courteous and kind and respectful to the peer, the one who is on the same level. With regards to the kabir and the saghir, the elder and the younger, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has mentioned from the hadith of Ibn Amr radiallahu anhuma, that is collected by Abi Dawood rahimahullah, he said, man lam yarham saghirana wa ya'rif haqqa kabirina falaysa minna, that whoever does not show mercy to our youth, to the young ones from amongst us, the youth, the children, whoever does not show mercy to them, and he does not know the right of our elders and the kabir from amongst us, then he's not from us. And he, meaning that he is not upon the path of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam properly and correctly. Not meaning he's not a Muslim, but meaning he has deficiency in his faith, and deficiency in his iman, and deficiency in his ittiba' and following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to show mercy and be kind to the youth and to the young ones and to the children, and to bear the fact that they're young and they have no experience, and to understand that and to deal with that, and they have desires that they're going through, especially the ones who are going through puberty, especially in these lands, that they will deal with them in a merciful way, in a kind way, and one will have to think about the position that they're in and the issues that they're facing and going through, and deal with them accordingly and not transgress the boundaries, causing them to go astray, being a means to lead them astray from the dealings and the likes. And likewise with the children and the youth and the babies, we deal with them with mercy and with kindness. وَيَعْرِفْ حَقَّ كَبِيرٍ. And likewise, he does not know the right of the elder, the right of the kabir, the one whose kabir is two types in Islam. The one whose kabir is the one whose kabir in sin. He's elder. He's an older individual. This person, he has to be honored, and his right has to be known. And this is from the sunnah. And the one who does not perform that right, the Prophet, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَلَيْسَ مِنَّا, then he's not from us. I mean, he's not upon our way. He's not upon our guidance. He's not following us properly, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And likewise, the other one who is known as kabir, likewise, there's the one who is kabir, and in his rank and in his status and his position, like the people of knowledge. Like the people of knowledge, also he's known as kabir. And likewise, in one wording of this narration, وَلَمْ يَعْرِفْ لِعَالِمِنَا حَقَّى, he doesn't know the right of our scholar and the right of the person of knowledge from amongst us, then likewise he's not from us. So knowing the rights of these people, this is from the sunnah and from the correctness and from the true following of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So the Shaykh, he says, وَيُوَقِّرُ الْكَبِيرُ وَيَحْنُ عَلَى الصَّغِيرُ وَيُجَامِلُ النَّذِيرُ, that he will honor and respect the elder, and he will be merciful and kind to the youth, to the younger, and he will deal courteously and kind in the best way with the one who is his peer. He will be courteous with him and kind to him, and show respect to him and the likes. Also with regards to the elder and the youth, the Salaf, they have mentioned with regards to how each one should look at the other. And this is a beautiful example and way that we should deal. Those who are elders, they should deal with the youth. And those who are youth, they should deal with and look at the issue of the elders. And that is that the elder, he looks at the youth, and he sees that they're young in age, and that their sins are few, because they don't have lived long enough to gather much sins. And they look at themselves that they've been older, so they have much sins. So they find that the youth is better and cleaner than them in this manner like this. The youth, they're not like, that is not like the elder. The elder, he will think like this. The elder, he's been alive a long time. He has gained and earned many sins and many actions of disobedience. And he has much shortcomings that have piled up upon him and against him. As for the youth, then he's new. He's fresh, alhamdulillah. He doesn't have that many sins like him. So then he will honor him likewise, and he will respect him and show mercy to him. As for the youth, then he will look at the the elder, and he will see him and how long he's alive and how much good deeds that he has performed and the likes, and he will see himself that he's shorter than that. He has more shortcomings than him. So he will look at the elder like this. He will look up at him and he will see that he's been living so long. How many times, how many Ramadans has he fasted? How many salawat has he prayed in the masjid? He's made it this age and he's still alive and he's still following the sunnah. How many good deeds has he acquired? How much great rank and status that he has? Therefore, he will respect him and he will honor him and he will show him his right. He will respect him and he will honor him and he will show him his right. Naam. So this is with regards to al-kibiri wa-saghir. So this is from the manners and the way that one deals with each other. خُلُّ الْعَفُ يعني مِنْ أَخْلَاقِ النَّاسِ يعني مَا سَمَحَتْ بِهِ نُفُوسُهُمْ نعم وسهلت سهلت من أخلاقهم. That which is easy for them, that which is easy for them, to pardon the people, to overlook them, to not expect the people to always be perfect, to always do exactly what you said, to always do exactly what you want. The one who wants the people to always be exactly how he wants, then he will never be happy and he will never be satisfied. And this person will be tired, and this person will be wore out. Because he will never be happy. He's like, wow, you didn't do this, you didn't do that. I asked you to do this, I told you to do that. I thought I said this, you didn't hear me. So, I mean, every single time he wants somebody to be exactly what he thinks is right, this is not going to happen. The people do not like that. The people do not like that. Sometimes they do good and sometimes they don't do good. Some people they do good more often and other people they fall into hard and difficulty, and some people they have money shortcomings and hardships and they're tried with that. So each one, a believer has to learn to deal with them properly. And in the best manner. And this is the command in this verse. خُذ الْعَفُ. And take that which is easy from the people. Take that which is easy for them to perform. We can't expect the children, for example, to do everything right the first time. To do everything right the first time. Because they have no experience and they haven't been taught. Rather, instead of if we ask them to do something and they don't do it or they don't perform it right, we should think, did we teach them how to do it? Before blaming them and finding fault with them and being harsh with them and yelling at them and so on and so forth, we should think, did we actually teach them how to do it? How can I expect the child to perform this particular deed in this action, like cleaning the house or helping with fixing the car or the dishes or whatever the case may be, from the chores of the house, even taking out the trash? Some children, they don't know how to do it properly. He'll just go out there and throw it on the ground. Or he won't tie it and he'll throw it and the trash will go everywhere. And not because he doesn't have experience. He doesn't know. Nobody taught him how to do that. So it's different if a person, he does it because he's lazy, he knows what to do it, and he refuses to follow the way. But the one who does not know or he has not been taught, he has to be dealt with differently. So if he makes some mistakes, خُذ الْعَفُ. And he pardon him, forgive him, overlook him, and try to help him rectify that and teach him. خُذ الْعَفُ. خُذ الْعَفُ. And he forgive the people, pardon the people. Likewise, the husband and the wife, the same thing. They pardon each other. They forgive each other. They overlook each other's faults in order to have a good relationship and to keep the family strong. خُذُ الْعَفُ. This is a great foundation and a fundamental that Allah has commanded His Prophet with sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we know it's incumbent for the believers to follow Him in that sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, so Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he has mentioned and he has said with regards to this, خُذُ الْعَفُ. He says, فَفِيهِ أَخْذُ الْعَفْوِ مِنْ أَخْلَاقِهِمْ وَإِحْتِمَالُ فَفِي أَخْذِ الْعَفْوِ مِنْ أَخْلَاقِهِمْ إِحْتِمَالُ آذَاهُمْ. He said, in the fact that a person, he will pardon and overlook them and forgive them and the likes like this, and he will accept from them what's easy from their manners, and in this manner, he is in reality, he is bearing their harm. He is bearing their harm. And so this person, for example, he falls short, he has some shortcomings. A person, he won't hold him to account for everything. And he will overlook that and he will know his situation and he will accept that from him. And this is the harm that one has to deal with. If we remember, Hassan al-Basri, what did he mention? The first thing about the good manners, kaf al-adha, to refrain from harming the people. To refrain from harming the people. And this means that if the people, they bring harm to you, don't harm them back. That you bear that, kaf al-adha. Naam, that you bear that. Well, and some of the salaf they mention likewise, كَفُ الْأَذَى وَبَذْرُ النَّدَى وَاحْتِمَالُ الْأَذَى وَاحْتِمَالُ الْأَذَى. And also to bear the harm from others. To bear the harm from others and to bear that burden. Somebody would harm a person, he doesn't harm him back. Somebody harm him, he will not even let him know. He would take his right. And the likes like this, for example, as I mentioned before, the one who took the person's spot in the masjid, he would, okay, it's all good, just let him have the spot, no problem. And he will look and he will go away. And he won't say anything. Alhamdulillah, it's easy for him.
يعني احتمال الأذى to even that person probably didn't even mean to harm him. So then he would just deal with that in order to avoid a bad situation. In order to avoid a bad situation. So to bear the burden and the harm of others, and by accepting their manners and their conduct as they are, and to deal with them based upon that, Shaykh al-Islam, he mentioned this is like, he says you have to, and this will occur in more than one way. And he mentioned, تَرْكُ مَا لَكَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ عَلَيْهِمْ نَمْ فَأَخْذُ الْأَفْوِ أَلَّا تَطْلُوبَ مَا تَرَكُوهُ مِنْ حَقِّكَ. He says that this would occur in one way like this, that you will leave the right that you have upon them. You have a right upon them, whether it's financially or physically or whatever the case may be, you have a right upon them. And they did not give it to you, or they refrained, or they refused to give the right, or they had fallen short in giving you your right. He says, so you pardon them, and you accept that from them, you go easy with them, and you do not ask them to give the right that they have taken from you. People, he didn't give him his right in his wealth, or in his money, or the likes like this, or in his item, or whatever the case may be. He deals with that in an easy way. Khalas, I just pass. It's my right. I let it go. Alhamdulillah. Not to get into any trouble, to get into any conflict, to go into any bad conversation, or anything like that. He just pass it and blow it off. Alhamdulillah. Like this. And he will not ask them to give him his right back. And he will pardon that. And he will do it with the people like this, only for the sake of Allah. Khud al-afu. Also, he says, وَأَلَا تَنْهَاهُمْ فِيمَا تَعَدُ فِيهِ الْحَدَّ فِيكَ. And likewise, do not prohibit them whenever they transgress the limits with regards to you. And if somebody, he goes beyond the limits, then, for example, he goes beyond the limits in speech. He starts talking bad, and he starts using names. He would not, at this time, he would accept that from him, and he would say, okay, I'm gone. Assalamu alaikum. And he will leave. And this is what will come in the end of the verse. We will discuss that inshallah. Wa'adid an al-jahileen. Whenever people start acting ignorant, he will see that this person is how he is. This person, he's foul. He's a rude person. He doesn't have manners. He came out of his conduct. He came out of his character. Khalas, I'll turn away from him. I accept that from him. Khalas. But you will not get involved in that. And you will not tell him, oh, you can't talk to me like that. This is my right. I'm your brother. I'm older than you. I'm your elder. He will not tell him just that, because he knows at this time that's not the best thing to do. Khud al-afu. Pardon him, forgive him, and leave that situation before one makes it worse. Before one makes it worse. We have more statements from the ulama with regards to this, and then some examples from the sunnah, and some examples from the Salaf al-Salih with regards to this issue, and this first great principle, and noble manners, خُذُ الْعَفُ. And he pardoned and be forgiving and easy with the people, easy in dealing with them and forbearing with them and pardoning them and forgiving them and accepting from them the good that they have, and likewise dealing with their deficiencies in the best manner. هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.